Hello, Ed.
And I'm really glad to be here today. The folks asked me to come on to talk about this particular product that we just released because it is really powerful. And there's a couple of things I'm going to tell you in here. There are just indicator combinations that work really well together. May not have looked at them before, so there's something for anyone in this presentation. But I will be talking about this approach to trading the real-time market. And we call it catch a wave. There's a history to it. I actually was singing the Beach Boys song early, but I had to stop doing that. So anyway, but catch a wave, and let's see why we call it that. If I go to my first slide here, you'll notice that this chart has a green zone. This is a 1 minute chart of MISO, and you got this green zone here and this red zone. So this is from WaveTrader. It's the fractal WaveTrader template, and what you find is that you know, in the green zone, that's the green wave and the red wave, and basically, the trading follows those two ideas, but there's a lot more to it than that. I want to go back to how this came about and honor someone who made me aware of this. You know, we've had WaveTrader around for a while, and the other indicators in here have also been in our arsenal for a while. But this gentleman, who is a very long-time Nirvana Club member, Larry Smith, has tried lots of things in the market, lots of day trading approaches. There's just a lot of energy, especially around the open, and that's where he wanted to trade. So he discovered this relationship that he brought to my attention back in February, late February, and it's pretty cool. I mean, we started watching him use it, and you know, in the market, and he was just like successful almost every day trading with this thing. And so we took it on and went about adding the rest of the story to it, which has to do with the platform and other things I'm going to show you in this webinar. But it really is a very, very powerful idea, and it's based on a couple things I'll just talk about briefly. The first is an indicator called a VWAP, which is volume weighted average price, and it's used by lots of day traders, has been actually for quite a while. It's a really good indicator for indicating changes in trend, especially. And so here that is plotted on this 1 minute chart. And generally above VWAP, especially going through VWAP to the upside, you have a really strong potential for an up move. And then down through VWAP, coming down through it, you have potential for a down move. So that's the first component. What Larry noticed was that when you have a move above VWAP and you have the green fractal, and this is created by essentially an Elliott wave process that looks at these waves in the market and produces the red and green color based on the pivots, on the wave pivots. So if you look at the, you know, when the wave is green, basically the formation of a higher low here, and you're above VWAP, typically you get these really nice moves. So I've got a couple of charts here that just show that really, really easily. So here's a chart that's kind of in the red wave. VWAP is that maroon line right there. So the chart goes through VWAP, gets into the green zone, and then takes off. The same as for this chart down here on dogs, going down through the maroon VWAP line and into the red zone, and that's a really bearish point. Actually, I was trading that one. That's why this was on here. But and these are the same time. So another great thing I love about trading, especially day trading, is that you can easily have charts that are going up and charts that are going down at the same time. So it's super tradable. But so those two indicators work really well together. If you have them, you can plot them and see. I think they're in different plugins. WaveTrader, of course. I think Intrinsic Trend is the other one. And they are really good together. Let me go ahead and now move on and just look at some examples of this. And these are actually examples that we were passing around in Skype that Larry was showing us, you know, how this works. And there you can see the red, you know, this is a moving average actually going through VWAP right there. In the red zone. That was a very nice move, about a 10% move on that stock right there. Great signal. Here's a couple of them. There's that VWAP line going across there, and then so dropping hard through VWAP. You've got a long signal there. Dropping hard through VWAP, you got that weakness coming in, and the same here, have the weakness. These often happen right at the open. That's where he likes to trade them. We found there's a lot more application than just the open, but this is actually a visual trader. And Constantine, he goes by Kosei Kraus, and our staff was playing with this, trying it early in the game to see how good it was. He was extremely impressed. This is a screenshot that he made, And there's his, the trade he actually did right there, a short trade, as he was looking at this with a really, really nice profit. So that's a look at what the signals look like in real time. And so let's go ahead and look at what we added to this, because you have the indicators, they're great, but there's a lot more to trading profitably than just having the indicators, because you have to do a lot of other things, as you know, besides just that. And so let's look at what that is. The first component of this thing that we released is Market Scans 2. And I'm going to bring it up here in a second. The main thing about this Market Scans version, if you've seen it before, we've actually had it for a while. But what happened was we started using it to find these setups, the primo setups in the market during the day. And you have to have a scanner because there's just too many stocks. You can't look at all of them. So it's like our other automated tools bringing signals to you and all that stuff, the scans that Angela was showing. Very important to do that, especially real time. So all the scans are here in the middle. The what the scan is defined on the right side. Then here are the actual candidates coming out of it. And so what he did was he added several really powerful features. I'm going to cover them in a second when I bring the software up. But that's the first component of it. The second is Visual Trader 12.5. The thing, Visual Trader, of course, is connected to Market Scans. The scan symbols can come in here. It is the most amazing platform for day trading. And it really has to do with the integration of all this stuff together in one place. And I'll kind of talk about that when I bring VT up in about 5 seconds. So you got those two things there, those two major platform components. And so let me go ahead and do that now. If I bring up, first off, Market Scans, okay, and I'll go ahead and expand it. Again, I've got several scans chosen in here. There's a catch-away scan, a couple of others that are included with the platform. And so they're listed here on the left. And what's really cool about this is Constantine added the ability to color code these so that the color represents a change in price from the prior day's close. So you look at the scan, you see these are all up quite a bit. Of course, we're after hours right now. This is after hours trading stuff. So not very many in here, but that's really pretty cool. You can see them coming in to the scan as they occur. So we had the color coding. He also added something that's really a cool feature, and that is these voice alerts, where it can actually speak the symbols as they're coming in. And that's really useful for using Market Scans just as a scanner with other software, because VT has another feature related to this. But that was a really great thing that he did also. But the big primo change to Market Scans, if you ever used a prior version, is that he worked on the server code to make it basically instantaneous. Like every second, it is looking across the entire market for this scan definition. You see all U.S. stocks up here, and it is basically real time. So if there is a breakout, if there is a sudden transition that works well with this technique, it'll show up in here like right away. And it used to be it would wait until the end of a bar to do that analysis, which is pretty, you would expect it to do that. You got to have the whole bar, right? Well, it's not doing that anymore. It's doing it on every single tick basically in the market, which means it's extremely fast in delivering these candidates over to Visual Trader. So I bring up Visual Trader now. Let me see here if I can get to it. All right. So those, of course, come into the list. You can see, you know, I've got some right here already loaded in here from what we're looking at. And so as they come in, essentially, what happens is, because I have, let me go ahead and go to the list here, the map. And people have always asked, what do you need these cylinders for? Why is this here? There are other things you can do with Visual Trader that have to do with seeing group strength and weakness. You can actually put a bunch of group plates out here with group symbols on them and watch the consensus, like a bunch of them become green, one group. So that's very useful. In this application with just Catchwave by itself, we're simply putting these scans on here. So I added the Catchwave liquid scan and the intraday mover scan, which finds things that are moving throughout the day. Catchwave is really oriented around the opening bell. And so those two are just added. And once they're added, of course, they're in here. So the symbols, they come into the list. And then as soon as a signal is generated, again, we're after market right now. As soon as the signal is generated, it will show up in this fired list and flash. And when it does that, the voice will say what the symbol is. It'll say ANC, catch a wave. It'll tell you the scan that it came from. So I can just sit here and wait for something to come in, and you can also tell the program with the alert that when that comes in, to go ahead and bring the chart up automatically, or bring up a floating chart that you can put on any monitor you want. So it's just like just kind of sitting here with a trot line or something, or you know, catfish pole in the water and waiting for a tug on the line. They come in, you click them, or they can come up automatically, and then you look at them and you say, okay, yeah, I've got a really strong crossing down through VWAP in the 1 minute chart, and you look, get a little momentum past that, and then you know there's a really good setup there. This particular setup, I have the daily, the 1 minute, and the 50 tick chart. These are almost the same. And then this is the market. I like watching the market while I'm doing any kind of trading just to see what it's doing. So that's the 1 minute on the QQQ. And of course, this can be anything. You can make any template you want with any charts on it, but this is kind of how I do it. And so, as I say, when they come in, you click them, and they'll come up in here, and you can just see these moves through VWAP accelerating as they gain, you know, from that point. So it's super, super powerful. And again, VT has also been sped up. Mainly the interaction between Visual Trader and Market Scans is so clean and so slick. It just performs. They come up, it tells you they're coming in, you click them. And then of course you can click the chevron in any chart. And that brings up the next thing that I want to tell you about, which is a really big enhancement for Visual Trader 12.5. And that is these hot buttons down here. So just the prior interface, you would set it up here with all of your stuff, you know, market, stop market, whatever, and you would submit your trade. Well, we added this down here, and these, you can add as many rows of buttons as you want. You can have as many columns as you want, and you essentially define them by going into edit mode. You see it's kind of yellow now. That means I'm editing these things. And so on this first one, see it says buy 10% of equity. Well, I could make that, I can type anything I want in there. I can make the color anything I want with this, right? There's the color. But essentially when I click on that button, it shows me what the setup is. So this is buy 10% of equity at market and default order route. If I click on this one, see it says buy 25% of my position size. So that's 25% of P. And we have a little drop downs here, so you have to remember what these things are. You can just bring them up right there. But each of these buttons then is defined to do, here's a sell 10% of equity market, and I can make them anything I want. So I can also tell it by going out of exit mode here. I can tell it to submit the order immediately, and I can also say keep this whole thing on the desktop. So literally, if I'm sitting in here in a trade, and let's say this is pulled back, it started to go back up through its moving average, and I want to buy some more, I just come here and click that. Just click it. And it just does it. It just keeps adding on to the position. And you can see up here, you'll see that the trades coming in to increase your position size or decrease it, depending on what you click. So it's just a really great new thing that we haven't been able to do before, to very quickly scale in, scale out of trades. And that's where a lot of profit can come from if you know you're on the right side of it. You go through VWAP and start to break through consolidation highs, as Angela was talking about. That's a powerful, powerful signal. So right there, I can double my trade size by clicking that twice. Really super easy. And so this, again, is the hot button improvement to the trade interface. And that's in VT 12.5, which is also available by itself. All right, so back to my little show here, if I can get back to it. Okay. All right. So we have these different components. There's the hot buttons. Yep. All right. So that's VT. So you've got these different things working together. Market Scan feeds the trades into here. They go into the alert list when they generate a signal. So the signal happens. They'll flash over here. It can tell you what the symbol is. You bring it up and either hot button in or do a traditional trade, and you can say use a trade plan or not use a trade plan. It's up to you, and you specify that. So super simple, and it just basically drive VT through the market. It's really pretty easy and fun. And folks around here have been trading with it for a couple weeks now since it was out, and pretty much everybody is profitable every day. Some a lot more than others, but they've all been having fun with it, just getting in there and doing it. go ahead and show a couple of recent signals from the catch-a-wave product. And you can just kind of see the energy as you get into the green wave and above VWAP. So here we're kind of flatlining, solid move through VWAP. That was a very nice long right there, back to the moving average, get out. And then another move here, you know, kind of at around lunchtime. So get another one. This is a beautiful one. Look at this, flatlining. At the open, it takes off above VWAP, taking off in the green, and then, okay, we're good. There's good shorts. See this short right here, right through VWAP going down? That's a classic right there. I think I got one more to show you. This is the early, near the open, which is really what the catch-away product was really designed to find is trades at the open. But like I say, we see plenty of opportunity to trade this thing during the day. Happens all the time. You can just keep going with it. And you can just sit there and wait for it to tell you that it has something. That's really cool. So those are just some recent signals to show you. Got one more here maybe. Yeah, May 28th, opening short on MOXC. And then as we were preparing to release the product, I did a trading test one day that was really fun. I got in and engaged the market. And I actually had one trade went against me and I didn't get out of it. I should have, like, you know, that story, right? I thought, wow, that just dropped too fast. It's going to come back. Well, it didn't. So I get out of it finally. But even with that loss, I was able to make up for it pretty easily to do this in about 45 minutes. So was really excited about that. Like I say, we're all using it every day and learning more about different tactics with it. It's just an amazing, amazing platform. The way it works is slick, folks. I'm telling you, it really, really is. So Catch a Wave is a complete real-time method that's easy to use. Everything you need is included, including educational seminars on how to trade it. So that is the Catch a Wave product.
Okay. Awesome. Thank you so much, Ed. Hey, before we lose you, Ed, I want to ask you a couple of questions here. Actually, not a couple of questions. I just want to comment on a couple of things. Two things you said that I just want to reiterate. One was the integration of the platforms. I saw three emails today mentioning how seamlessly they work together. And it's like it's one platform almost. So amazing job by those guys. And you had that one slide. And I didn't want to interrupt you, but it's really something to see those work together. Yeah, go ahead.
Oh, with the different parts working together?
Yeah. Oh, absolutely.
Yeah, and you can just minimize market scans, you know, in this separate application. But like you say, they act like one, really. And that's
they really do.
Cool. Yeah.
And the other thing is, yes, it was designed, as you talked about, for like rapid fire, hot button trading at the open. But if you had a lunch hour or some time in the afternoon, you know, I don't like to do that open stuff, as you know. So it's kind of nice to sit down and you can catch a wave just about any time in the market because the scanner is finding the stuff that's really moving out there and putting it right into your visual trader.
It is. I'm glad you came back on for a little MC work there because I want to give you kudos for the strategies you made for this thing and the scans. You got you know, credit where credit's due because you worked on that really hard. And it's a big part of the success of it. So thanks for doing that work.
Well, I appreciate it. And by the way, we're doing more work on that. For those of you who already own it or think about buying it, we have more strategies coming out and scans. This is not the end of Catch a Wave. It is just the beginning. And so we are really excited about this product moving ahead. All right.
There's the website, by the way, if anybody wants to read more about it or see videos. We have demo videos up there and other things. So it's just our website /catch-a-wave. That's it.
Excellent. Yeah. Hey, thank you, Ed. I hope to see you on Market Pulse here again soon.
Okay, I'll do it.
All right. Hey, we have one more person that we want to visit. Now, Jason, go ahead and drop that link in. We've put out a couple of emails showing how the different people, and you know, this is what Ed was talking about. Different people are looking at the Catch-a-Wave product and they're approaching it differently. And already, Jason, who you're going to meet here in just a little bit, put out a video saying, hey, here's how I did. And he's really good at this stuff. And then I put out a video just this morning saying, here's how I do it. I'm a little more conservative and I don't like the open and whatever. But this is my approach and I've had success with it. Well, let's look at another approach with it. And we're going to bring on now our COO, Steve Belknap, who has been trading. We've all been trading with Catch a Wave, but Steve's going to come on and talk about the way that he's been using Catch a Wave in order to approach the market. Welcome to Market Pulse, Steve.
Hi. Thanks for the invite.
Yes.
Congratulations on the milestone the 50th day anniversary.
Yes.
And I've been knowing Jeff 25 years and Angela about the same, and Ryan for 10. So, but watching them always is impressive. Y'all do a great job at breaking down the market, the software, the techniques, and it's fun to watch. Always learn something. And congratulations on putting this together and sustaining it.
Well, thank you. We appreciate that.
Absolutely. And I appreciate it. Angela just walked by, so she's here with me.
You keep talking, and I'm going to fix your audio.
So Angela's going to work on audio, just like everything. She always makes the sound, and it's hard to make me look good at this stage.
If it's possible, she does it. Thank you.
There you go. Much better.
Thank you very much. So, yeah, like Jeff was saying, you know, different time zones, different times you can get in the market, and then availability. They asked me if I'd come on and look at a few things with them, and I said, yeah, but it was a busy Monday morning, and I was already pretty well booked up. But I said, well, I'm going to take 30 minutes out of the morning, and kind of like Jeff, I was going to wait for the market to get going before I came on. So I turned on Catch a Wave, and I've got this now as my primary map, and I'm slowly bringing in a few industry groups that I like. But what they were commenting about is this, the seamlessness at which the market scans come into Visual Trader. And I don't even leave the market scans up anymore. I just minimize it off my screen. And what happens is the alerts fire, and you'll see the candidates come in, and this is aftermarket. So I left it running, and so here's the close at 3 o'clock, and all this, all these signals have come in aftermarket. And so what I did this morning is I had my initial meetings, and at 8:50, I sat down and I started watching the scans that were coming into the list, just as I am now. And so these are post-market, but in the pre-market, at 8:30, I turned on the scans. These are the ones that came in that I selected to trade, and so I pushed off in the first. I made a little account and named it June 14th. This is in Visual Trader. You can create a new account on any day and go day by day to keep a tracker record for yourself. This is in the, I was in paper trading this morning when I did this. So as I sat down and started to get candidates coming up on my screen, the first one that I saw and confirmed was at 8:50, and it was a symbol SENS. And in prior lives, I never traded symbols that I didn't know really well, but I started to get really comfortable with the wave scan with the 9 period moving average crossover. And I started to realize that is a really powerful setup, and I can trust it. And I can trust it in the smaller time frames and on signals that I'd never seen before. And they're coming into the scan because they're moving. So the first time I fired off a trade was right at 8:50. I had see if I can move this. So I had a great setup because I had the crossover, I had the color chart change, the crossover, the moving average, and it crossed over VWAP. So I said that looks good. I jumped in, didn't stay long, and I did that. So I'll just show you the different trades, and this was all in about 20 minutes. So that was the first one. Then this Corsair Gaming came into view right at 8:50, and I got a quick profit on it and got out. And then UONE, same time frame. This was right about 9, and this signal came in. The color chart transform changed, and I got a crossover of the moving average. So that was a quick in and out. And then ENOB was a similar time frame. I came in right about here, and then I exited within the next, none of these trades were more than 5 minutes, with the exception of Piton, which I came in twice. So on a $100,000 account, it ramped up to almost $800 in the morning minutes that I had available to say, well, I'll just turn this on, find the candidates, and see what we can do in the time frame that I had allotted. So about 20-25 minutes, and the I would never have seen these candidates. I never would have knew that I should be looking at them without the benefit of the scanner serving them up. And then as I was watching these signals occur through the day, I started bringing in industry groups that I followed for years and years. And so here's the bank stocks, Capital One, Bank of America, JP Morgan. And right at 10 o'clock, and typically you don't want to short these stocks before 9:30, but at 10 o'clock, signals on all of them, and they had the cross, the zone turns, and the wave changes color, the color chart, and the VWAP, or the nine period moving averages, crosses over, and I know that's a strong setup. And in this case, the confirmation was across each one of the four stocks that I track in that group. And it made for a great, great trade at 10 o'clock. And the oil stocks looked similar in their timing today. They rolled over about 10, and again had these the color chart changes, confirmation with crossing over the nine period moving average, and in this case crossing VWAP all at the same time. And those were great trades. And as I've started to put my watch list more so on this version of Visual Trader following catch a wave, Caesar and Jeff commented, I said, how do you find topping stocks? And I told him, look, when they're at highs and they start to not be able to go higher, and the daily charts start to look like this one, where they're really not going anywhere anymore, and you're getting red and green alternating charts, I said, it looks like the Watusi at the top. And I can't believe you remembered that from 15 years ago, Jeff. But in this stock today, Caesars, and you can go back in the signals that came in on this were outstanding. These color chart shifts, and again, this is where the wave, the nine period moving average crosses with the wave. And I'll use this as a signal with or without a signal, because I know how powerful this zone is right here. When you get this cross with a new color chart, that's a powerful zone to be in. And it happened here, here, and here. And then on the biggest move of the day, it hit it on the first bar out. And we've been talking about, well, how do you know when to exit? And Ryan Olson said, look, as long as you're on the nine period moving average hasn't closed below the candle, stay in long or short. And this got us all the way down to here on that. And if I hadn't been watching, I might have missed that and stayed in even longer. So really great opportunities just being brought to you throughout the market day. And then, like Ed was saying, so click the T chevron. This is the new quick trade, or the new hot buttons. And I was just coming in, and I'd see the entry, I'd click sell 10%. You hit submit, and if you don't have the submit immediately turned on, it'll show you what it's about to do. And then you just hit submit and your trade's off and away. When you want to cover it, you can just use the individual cancel or close button on the form and do it that way. And one other way to use Visual Trader to track trades is if you've got more than one open position and you want to use the charts to manage it, these are closed because I closed everything for the end of the day. But if you hit shift and click, it'll load all the symbols. And if this is in your open trades, you can do that. And you can simply track them that way, or you can do a plot a floating chart and move it to one of the other monitors. So I've just had an absolute blast using this. And I'm also looking at it in the pre-market now, and I'm starting to get a lot more confident with these pre-market trades. And I'm going to show you one last symbol that I never heard of this stock. I'd never seen blue, the symbol blue. But I came across it a couple of days ago using Catch a Wave. And when it fired this morning and went straight up, and then here's the wave change, and here's the crossover with 9-period moving average. And what a great entry on the short side on blue this morning. And I'm telling you, folks, it's just exciting. Whatever time of day you want to turn it on and get involved. And one other stock that came to my attention because of Catch a Wave was CLF. And it was hot as a firecracker last week, and I started watching, and I think the confirmation periods down here are really good. You got the ones, the fives, and the dailies. The signals only fire in the ones, but I'll bring up the daily to see where is this in space. Where are we with this stock on a daily basis? Then I'll look at the fives, and then I'll trade in the ones. And this was a terrific signal in the afternoon. Here's the color chart change. Here's the crossover with the 9-period moving average. And Jeff polished it off with the signal. And then, you know, trade management's up to you. A lot of these signals and strategies will get out pretty quickly with a profit. But once again, you can also use the crossover, the 9-period moving average for exits, which in this case would have kept you in the trade all the way to here. Kudos for putting all this together, Ed. It was really his brainchild and Kosei's ability to come in and turn the scanner loose on the market at a rate of speed that finds these candidates for you.
Yeah.
And it's happening all day long. I'm astonished at how many things I didn't know were going on in the market. Never had a chance, never saw the opportunities and wouldn't have. So we're just going to keep making this better and better. These are the early stages. We're using it. Jeff's looking at where we're saying, hey, we saw this particular exit that was maybe faster than the signal, and he just goes back in and makes adjustments. So anybody that gets into this product, these are not the early days, but they're certainly in our discovery days, and it's only going to get better, and it's really, really good. So thanks for letting me get on the show and talk about it. I've always loved Visual Trader, and now they've got Catch a Wave. If you don't have it, get it. And believe me, once you turn it on, you won't turn it off.
No, I agree 100%, Steve. Thank you so much for coming on. And, you know, it's just great to see different ways of approaching the market. You know, in fact, I just tried to put a link. I did it in YouTube. I don't do it in Facebook, Jason. Maybe you can help me out there, showing how Jason approaches it. I'm a strategy guy. I do the strategies, do the trade plans. And Steve, you know, little of both. You're doing that different times a day. And like he said, it's really amazing as far as the opportunity throughout the day. You always thought, hey, you got to trade in the morning. That's the only time the market moves. Not true. And we're finding through the scanning what's actually moving out there. So really excited about that product. So, hey, Steve, thanks again.
Thank you, Jeff.
You bet.